Welcome back to our channel. We are here with new topic. We already made two tutorials on plant seeds. If you haven't watched those, please do watch to understand this class clearly. Link is up there. We are going to discuss about seed germination today. Let's learn. Germination is the awakening of dormant embryo. In all mature angiosperming seeds, the embryo lies in a dormant state when its physiological activities come to a minimum. Even its respiration is so slow as to be detectable only by few sensitive instruments. As soon as the necessary conditions are satisfied, this dormancy is broken and the phenomenon of germination begins. There are few external and internal factors which are necessary for germination. External factors are moisture, oxygen, optimal temperature and light. There are internal factors as well, which are food and auxin, the growth hormone, completion of resting period or the dormancy period, and the viability of seeds. No seed can get germinate unless it is thoroughly moistened. Digestion, respiration or conduction cannot go without water. The swelling of the embryo enables it to burst through the seed coat. Oxygen cannot get through the testa unless it is moist. The need of oxygen is greater during germination as respiration and all other physiological activities are more vigorous at this stage. Optimum temperature range varies plant to plant. Seeds are not usually expected to germinate below 0 degrees centigrade and above 50 degrees centigrade, and optimum often lies between 25 to 30 degrees centigrade. In case of light as an external factor, it has great importance in germination. Tobacco, rumex, mistletoe seeds do not germinate in darkness, while the tomato or datura seeds do not need light to germinate. Food is essential as internal factor in germination. It has already been seen that this food may be contained in the cotyledons, as in protein and starch in pulses, oil in mustard, groundnut, sunflower, or in form of endosperm like starch and little protein in cereals, oil in castor, coconut, cellulose in date, perisperm in case of black pepper, tester for pomegranate. Auxins are growth promoting substances which is essential for growth during germination. Many angiospermic seeds have to undergo a period of dormancy. Many cereals are capable of germination immediately after harvesting, while others do not germinate till after a year. Seeds retain their viability for a definite period of time, after which the embryo becomes dead for all practical purposes. Viability test is necessary to ascertain the germination capacity of any seed. The longest authentic record of this period of viability is Nelumbium speciosum seed, whose age has been calculated to be 800 years. When all the necessary conditions are satisfied, the first change noticed is swelling of the seed by rapid imbibition and the osmosis of water. This may cause a bursting of the seed coat. Absorption of water causes a vigorous resumption of physiological activities by the protoplasm. There is a rapid respiration and an abundant secretion of enzymes, which causes digestion of stored food. Insoluble food is rendered soluble and complex food made simple. This simple food solution is diluted by water and conducted towards the growing epicotyl, hypocotyl, radical and plumule. Food is translocated from perisperm to endosperm, from endosperm to cotyledon, and from cotyledon to the growing organs, according as which of them are present in the seed. Assimilation of this food by the growing organ enables growth, and seedling soon assume its ultimate shape. When the seed is placed in the soil and growth has become vigorous, the radical is the first organ to grow vigorously. It comes out through the micropyle and fixes the seeds to the soil. After this, either the hypocotyl or the epicotyl begins to grow. When the hypocotyl grows fast, it pushes the cotyledonary node and all the other parts of the seed, with or without the seed coat, out of the soil, and the mode of germination is called epigeal or epigenous. When the epicotyl grows first, only the plumule is pushed out of the flower, while the cotyledonary node, cotyledons and all other parts remain under the soil. This type of germination is called hypogeal or hypogenous. In monocots, however, the hypocotyl does not grow, but the epigenous and the hypogenous nature is determined by the growth of the cotyledon itself. In this tutorial, we are describing epigeal germination only, and the next mode of germination, that is hypogeal germination, we will be discussing in our next video. Epigeal germination is shown by some dicotyledonous plants and a few monocots. Common examples of this type of germination are found in dicotyledonous exalbuminous for cucurbits, mustard, tamarind, French beans, Tolicos lablab and sunflower. In case of dicotyledonous albuminous, castor. Monocotyledonous albuminous is very rare but found in onion, and monocotyledonous exalbuminous found in Alisma plantago. The first example is gourd, the Cucurbita maxima, the scientific name of it. As germination begins, the straight radical comes out and fixes the seed to the soil, with the secondary roots coming out of the radical. The hypocotyl next grows so quickly that it forms a loop which comes out of the soil and pulls out the rest of the seed. Frequently, the seed coat gets caught to a pig-like projection at the base of the hypocotyl so that it is cast off easily and the cotyledons are brought out in the air. Next, the cotyledons open out like two leaves, become green, large and thin so that they look and behave like ordinary leaves in every way, though differing in form from normal cucurbita leaves. The plumule within the cotyledons become exposed and soon grows into the aerial shoot. In case of mustard, the seed coat is thinner, the two cotyledons are much oily and the radical is curved in the tiny seed. The stages of germination are essentially the same as in the cucurbits. Tamarind, the tester in this case is very hard. Nevertheless, the radical comes out first after the tester is burst and fixes the seed by forming a root system. The hypocotyl now grows fast and soon pulls out the two large and thick cotyledons. The plumule then grows out into the aerial shoot. The cotyledons turn greenish, gradually shrivel up and finally drop off as the food matter within them is used up. The cotyledons, although turning greenish, never look like ordinary leaves as they do in cucurbita. In case of lablab and French bean, both of them germinate like tamarind. The fleshy cotyledons do not become leafy but behave like tamarind cotyledons. Lablab is the common flat bean of the plains. In case of castor, the shale-like tester first busts near the caruncle and the radical grows out. Subsequent growth of the hypocotyl pulls out of the soil the two thin cotyledons enclosed in the endosperm. The tester is cracked and is soon consumed by the former. The cotyledons then open up and become green and leafy, while the plumule slowly develops into the leafy shoot. The remnant of the endosperm wither and drops off. Epigenous germination is very rare among the monocots. Onion is one of the very few examples. In this case, the radical as well as the base of the curved cotyledon, that is also known as scutellum, grows out of the seed. The radical penetrates the soil while the other end of the cotyledon remains within the endosperm and sucks the food material. The base of the cotyledon grows further, turns green and pushes the seed out of the soil. The plumule is not visible so long as it is covered by the base of the cotyledon in the form of a sheath just above the radical. The plumule now pierces this cotyledon sheath and forms the first cylindrical foliage leaf. Meanwhile, adventitious root develop from above the radical, forming a fibrous root system, which is a characteristics of monocots. It should be noted in this case that the seed is pushed out of the soil not by the growth of the hypocotyl as in other cases, but by that of the base of the cotyledon itself. There is another exceptional example is Peperomia peruviana. This is a dicot with endosperm and perisperm showing a peculiar type of germination. During germination, one of the cotyledons remains hypogeal within the endosperm, sucking the food material from the latter as well as from the perisperm, while the other cotyledon becomes epigeal and green. So these are few examples of epigeal mode of germination of seeds. I went through the seed germination chapter from this book. That's it for today's class. We will learn about hypogeal germination in our next video. So stay connected. Please subscribe our channel, hit the like button showing your support, put a comment below for any query or suggestions. Thank you.